Hello everyone, welcome to class 12 physics classes. In this video, we will study properties of charge. Properties of charge. There are few properties of charge. Number one, like charges repel each other. Like charges repel. Unlike charges attract each other. Suppose if we have two like charges, positive positive or negative negative, they will repel each other. Or unlike charges, like positive negative, they attract each other. Number second property is additivity. Additivity. According to this property, charge can be added by simple rule of algebra. Charge can be added by simple rule of algebra. Simple rule of algebra. It means if we add a positive charge or a negative charge, it will give neutral, zero. Neutral body. By this property, charge named as positive charge and negative charge. This is second property of charge. That is, charge can be added by simple rule of algebra. Now third property, quantization of charge. Quantization of charge. According to this property, charge is discontinuous. Charge is discontinuous. Discontinuous. It means charge is integral multiple of elementary charge. Charge is integral multiple of elementary charge. Elementary charge means Q equals to N E, where N are number of electrons, E charge of electron, Q total charge of the body. Q is net charge of the body. N total number of electrons in the body, and E is charge of electron. Charge of electron, that is minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. According to this property, if we want to give 1.2 electrons a body, it is not possible. 1.2 electron, 1.5 electron, 2.6 electron. We can give only 1 electron, 2 electron, 3 electron. That is integral multiple. So it is not possible. It means charge is discontinuous. Charge is integral multiple of elementary charge. Now, one question from this property. How many electrons are present in 1 coulomb of charge? How many electrons are present in 1 coulomb of charge? 1 coulomb of charge. In this question, net charge of the body is 1 coulomb, means Q equals to 1 coulomb. And charge of electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. And we have to find how many numbers? We have to find n. So by this formula, n equals to q upon e. Q is 1, a is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. On solving this, we get 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 electrons. It means in a single coulomb, there are 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 electrons present. Now, next property is conservation of charge. Conservation of charge. Conservation of charge. By the law of conservation of charge, the net charge of an isolated system will always remain constant. This law states that, says that the net charge of an isolated system, net charge of an isolated system will always remains constant. Will always remains constant. Net charge of an isolated system will always remains constant. Now, what is isolated system? Isolated system means a system in which no matter or energy is being exchanged with the surrounding. No matter or energy is being exchanged with the surrounding. That system is called isolated system. It means that any system that is not exchanging mass or energy with its surrounding will never have a different total charge at any two times. Suppose this is an isolated system. This is an isolated system. And suppose two bodies are in this system. And net charge of the body is zero. Net charge of the body is zero. Now, this body is transferring some electrons to this body. Due to excess of electron, this becomes negatively charged body. And the reduced number of electron will have a positive charge. Reduced number of electron will have a positive charge of the same magnitude. So this body have positive charges of same magnitude. It means that after charging, net charge is also zero. So the net charge of an isolated system will always remains constant. Here one more thing, we can create or destroy charges in pairs. Charges in pairs can be created or destroyed. Now suppose a positive charge, positron and electron, we are combining them, they give energy. This process is called annihilation. Here in this equation we destroy electron, but in pairs. And one, if we give energy to heavy metal like platinum, gamma energy, they give a positive charge, negative charge and a positive charge, positron, an electron and a positron. This equation is called pair production. Pair production. here we can create charges in pairs. So these are properties of charge.